Hi there. One more episode of another museum, something totally different. And this museum is called as Goa Kruti. What this museum is about, let us go in and see. It's in a beautiful little house over here. Let's enter it and see what this Goa Kruti Museum is. This is how they used to have the gates for the old house. Now, I have been told that I'll be meeting a guide by the name Mr. Sushant Fernandez inside over here. Where? Look. Look at this beautiful door. So, when I came here, I found that there was this big wooden structure over here. Now, this is the door. I have to meet Sushant on the other side. How do I open that? I'll show you. There, I have slid the door. I'm going to go in. Ladies and gentlemen, the first thing that you do when you come inside the house, if you're wearing a hat, they have got something over here. We can hang our hat over here. Hello, Sushant.
Hi.
Sushant Bab, you are going to show us what is this museum called as Goa Kruti.
Kruti means work. Earlier days, whatever work was going on over here, Kruti is the colonial past of Goa.
Oh.
You'll see Kruti Museum right from the legal section to the medical section.
Oh.
Yeah.
Very nice. Let's go and see it.
Come. After you.
Thank you. So Sushant Bab, what is this section?
This is a legal section, law section.
Okay.
They are set up of office.
Okay.
Over here.
So this is how the legal fraternity the advocates used to work during this time. And these photographs are of all the judges.
All judges, original judges.
Of in Goa.
Yeah.
Very nice. Ladies and gentlemen, can you believe it? That we have got a whole range of photographs which list out all the judges that were here during the Portuguese time till 1961. That's what I was told about. So you can see that there is a typewriter, there is a place to keep the hang the stamps. Here is a thing that you
to seal
with lacquer, and there is a telegraph machine. I don't think you even know what is a telegram machine, but they used to send messages and telegrams by this particular machine. And do you know what this is? Pencil sharpener. Beautiful. So let us find out from Sushant Bab what next section is going to take us. Sushant Bab?
We will take you to the costumes and jewelry section.
Okay.
Wherein you will see vestments of the old priests which were they using, stoles and all. You can see over here.
Oh, this one.
Yeah, and the jewelries.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to thank Mr. Victor Hugo Gomes for allowing us to bring this Goa Kruti, his new baby, to all of you. Right now, they are in preview stage. They have not yet inaugurated. So you are being very, very privileged to see a new museum that is coming up, and that is Goa Kruti.
These are capstans and all, coats used by the olden Portuguese people.
Okay.
Folding chairs, rocking chairs.
And we see a lot of walking sticks here. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a big privilege or a matter of pride to walk in the village with a walking stick that was carved out of something. Here we can see a lot of walking sticks, and one walking stick I can see is this one where they would open it up and then sit when they were tired. See, they had provisions for everything. So let's see now what Sushant Bab has to tell us more.
We'll go to the clock, furnitures, guns, and the crockery section.
Ladies and gentlemen, when you come to the museum, don't touch anything because they have kept guns here. Not that they will shoot you, but these are priceless objects. Please don't touch anything. Museum, artworks, artifacts are not to be touched because our sweat on the hand spoils it sometimes. Sometimes you don't know, this gun may go off. Don't touch it. So besides these guns, you see a clock that was used by the industries for their punching the time of the employees. These are all the wall clocks, and this is the grandfather's clock. Sushant Bab, I love this chair. What is this chair about?
It is a lover's chair.
Lover's chair?
Yes, so both the faces can see each other.
Oh, so the boy could sit this side and the girl could sit that side and they could talk.
Talk easily.
Wow, I love this chair because it is the love chair. Sushant Bab, what is this big bottle?
This is a garrafon. Used to store vinegar, wines and all. Used earlier days.
Okay.
We have many of those kinds and all.
Okay. Quite a lot of liquid to be stored.
Yeah, liquid. A lot of vinegar was used in Goa.
Yes.
So that's why this garrafon was used.
Okay, and these altars were used by...
These were used in houses. Individual house had an altar like this kind and all. Whenever we used to enter the house, in front of the... Before they used to not have the sitting room, but the god was first before them.
Yes, yes.
They always used to have at the entrance only the altar.
Altar. Okay, now another thing that I want to ask you is that here in this chair, I see this netting, which is not nylon. What is that?
That is made from
cane bamboo
and all.
Cane bamboo.
Yeah, this is cane bamboo.
Okay, and this is called as the rotesam.
Rotesam. We call it rotesam in Goa.
Rotesam. Very good.
Cutlery is made out of silver.
Okay. Now, is this what they call as the German silver?
Yeah, German silver.
Okay. So Sushant, after this garrafon and all, what is the next section that is?
We have the old photography and all, then armors, then mask,
okay.
Baby cradles, simple carved baby cradles and all you can see. Then dressing table for male, female.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look at these cradles, the two cradles which are here, you can just visualize what was the artistry over here? What was the mastery of those carpenters or their tools to make such wonderful thing? Here you can see a lot of masks. Possibly, they are not of Goa, but earlier houses, they had different masks when they came from Africa or any other places. But these are just for show here. Here, we can see a lot of old cameras and lot of arms. I can see a helmet with a net, metal net. You have got the kukris. You have got the chest and the back protection plates. You have got a sword and you have got a spear. Dare not touch anything, otherwise they are well prepared. Okay? So, Sushant Bab, that we have seen all these carvings and all, I can see a lot of musical instruments.
Yeah, there are a lot of musical instruments over here, like the clarinet, the saxophone, trumpet, a pocket trumpet also is there on top.
Okay.
You can say bongo and all.
So, Goans were basically known for their music, playing the music, writing the music, very, very important, because even today when we talk of the Bollywood in Bombay, the film industry in Bombay, they acknowledged one of the greatest Goan songwriters and producers who wrote music for the first time in that industry. That is Mr. Anthony Gonsalves of Majorda. So Goa has got a long relationship with music. I think Goans have got music in their blood. What else they have in the blood, we'll not talk about. But right now, we'll talk about music. You can see a lot of musical influence, Western and Indian. So Sushant Bab, now that we have made music, we have seen music, we've understood the different things over here. What is the next section?
We have the last section, the medical section.
Yes.
Wherein the first medical hospital was there in Goa, established in
1800. Okay.
So you will find the first medical college, Goa Medical College. You will find the instruments used.
From there?
Yeah, from the hospital.
Okay. Just for your information, ladies and gentlemen, the Eshkol Medic, the Chirurgic, the Nova Goa was the name of the medical college when it came from Paneli near Ribandar into Panjim. In Panjim, it was established in the Makineses Palace. This was in the later part of 1800s. And in 1929, the new building that we see today of Old Goa Medical College in Panjim, which is now being used for exhibitions next to INOX, that building was the first medical college in the southern hemisphere. Can you believe it? What a pride we should be. We had the first allopathic medical college anywhere in the southern hemisphere in Goa. That is besides the point. So we have got a lot of things to be proud of. But now that we have come into this area where there are medical equipments and different things that have been kept, we never know. Sometime or the other, we have had a tablet or had a syringe. Let's see if we can spot any one of them over here. I see a box here. Now this is how they used to take your pressure. And next to that, I see a tiffin box. Please, ladies and gentlemen, we are in an area which is displaying a lot of medical items. So I can't expect that this tiffin is the regular tiffin that we eat in. But this particular tiffin was used to keep cotton and syringes and etc. in this. Can you see, doctors also needed tiffins at that time. Let's see what else they have. One more thing. Here, I see a lot of those eyepieces. Many a times, I use glasses. Many people have to go to the ophthalmologist. Now you have got machines that tell you this is your number, the variance of your eye lens. But here, they used to put this and say, Ata bare dista? Ka ata bare dista? Sounding familiar? He would take, put this. Ata bare dista? Na? Ata bare dista? Very important. Ata bare dista is very, very important to keep your sight clean. This is what it was. These tools that you see over here are originally from the doctors that were there at the Goa Medical College, and these are tools that were used during the operation. You can see how beautiful they are. Yes, they are rusted a little bit, but at one time they saved lives. So here we are in a place where there is a setup of a medical or a hospital bed. Many times you may have gone over here, you find the patient over here, next to him you have got this with a bottle and a pipe going into him, and then this chair for you to sit down, and all these things. When you go to the hospital, I hope you take fruits and all to those people, then they keep them inside over here. And then for him to wash or her to wash her hand, we had this bowls over here. So you can see how this setup has been made. And more so, if you look, we have got a table over here. Looks like the operation table, because I can see a lot of scissors. What Sushant is telling me, that this is not an operation table, this is a delivery table. If you have been born in Goa Medical College, you never know, this table may have been there. But I get scared of the scissors. So ladies and gentlemen, here I am in this museum, Consolidated Museums, where I'm sitting on a sopo, which is a very traditional Goan thing of the Indo-Portuguese architecture. A place like this needs to be visited by a lot of people. You, whenever you come to Goa on your visits, or you are in Goa, you have got a holiday, please come over here. Any of these travel agents, when you have your tourists coming in over here, please bring them here to these museums. And let us find out from Miss Noella, who is looking after the marketing of this place over here, what she has to tell all of us. Noella bhai, welcome to my program, My Goa. And I would like you to tell my viewers who are spread all over the world, in India as well as in Goa. We have a lot of viewership in Goa. Please tell them about how and what and when and where they should come to see this beautiful.
So there's so much to learn at Goa Chitra and all the three museums, and there's so much to see. And I feel if you truly love Goa, if you love her heritage, her culture, her music, her food, all of those things, if you really love and if you really want to respect, then this is the correct place to come, because it has all the objects and artifacts that tell you about our community, about our ancestors, yours and mine. And yours. And we have so many visitors from around the world that come, especially students from so many schools. And this is the place, teachers, children, parents, please come here, please learn. You can leave your textbooks and leave your classrooms and for one day come to a museum and learn in a different way. And if you want to contribute to Goa Chitra, there's a very simple way that you can do it. You can take out your phone right now, your mother's phone, your brother's phone, and you can open Facebook and you can join the Goa Chitra Museum Facebook page. And you can also open Instagram. We have wonderful posts where we talk about objects of the day. We talk about our artifacts, the history. We talk about all our visitors who come. We talk about the events at Goa Chitra. We have wonderful events here. And there is no better way to travel back into time than to come here.
Great. I don't think you need a better invitation than that. Ladies and gentlemen, it is us Goans who have to work hard in Goa to preserve what was there of Goans. It's no point just saying, I am a Goan, I am a Goenkar, Goenkar Pond. It is of no use if you don't contribute partly or wholly to preservation, protection and promotion in its authentic way, like they do it here in Goa Chitra, Goa Chakra and Goa Kruti. You must contribute your might to keep alive the original culture of a Goan. There you are. Thank you, Noella bhai.
Thank you.
There is a saying in English that if you want a tree to grow tall and its branches should touch the sky, you should have roots that should go down and they should be very strong. So basically what you are doing is, as much as you are trying to let the branches go up to the sky, you are allowing the roots to go deeper and deeper to understand the modes, methodologies and the arts that were there much, much earlier to our time.
Yeah, basically because in today's time, every development that you see is a selfish development. You don't see a future. So that makes you question, how did we have this beautiful Goa for so many generations? So that means our ancestors preserved it for us. You know, it's always good to understand that we are borrowing the world and the reserves from the future generation, not like the way we develop today. We don't even think of our own children, you know. Okay, our ancestors never did that. I think that is what we need to learn. This is what we are trying to give as a message.
Now that we have spoken about Goa Chitra and Goa Chakra, your latest intervention for Goans and their past is Goa Kruti. Can you tell us something about that?
Sanjeev, history is history. We can't deny, we can't manipulate. We were under the Portuguese for 451 years or whatever. Of course, maybe parts of Goa and the later, the new conquest came later.
Yes.
But the changes that happened is part of our history. Okay. But they also gave us some of the most beautiful things in this part of the world as the first. Like, for example, the first medical college in all of Asia was set up in Goa. Can we deny that? The first printing press, immediately after it was invented, it came to 1556. Can we deny that? How many of us know that Goa was one of the first state to be surveyed in 1898? Okay, and Goa was the only state that was surveyed from the whole to the part, whereas rest of India was surveyed from the part to the whole. How many of us know? Isn't it something that that is to be proud about? Goa Kruti is a tribute to that, the first that happened. Recently, I acquired this huge collection of medical gadgets that were used in Scuola Medica, okay, in 1948, okay, which will be supplementing the collection which I already had. Like, for example, we have the original photographs of each and every director of the first medical college.
Okay,
we have the original photographs of each and every judge that passed through Goa till 1960. We have the original judgments, okay, the fish cards, you know, the summary of the judgment. The original judgments are with us, not with the government or archives or with the Portuguese. These are things which are foolishly being sold by the government. Most of these things I have collected from scrapyards, not even antique dealers. Whenever the courthouse was being renovated, without checking, they gave everything for scrap. And luckily, there's a person like me who's going, you know, searching for things. Otherwise, by now, that would have been pulped or destroyed.
This Kruti, what is the objective of this? I mean, what is it that you are showcasing there?
Basically, the colonial past.
Okay.
Yeah. How we have evolved in different ways, like medicine, or legal system. Hmm. Okay, then...
the professions?
Different professions,
okay.
Yeah. Again, even the furniture, how, you know, we always talk about, you know, rest of the states which were under the British. It's a straight colonial furniture. It never evolved in India. Whereas in Goa, we can proudly say that there was a fusion that was evolved. What we call Indo-Portuguese furniture is the furniture that was born out of Goa using the Western elements. Okay, like if you look at the furniture, you know, the mermaids or the shell or the monsters. Okay, these were beautiful depictions of the stories that were brought in by the sailors, okay, and reproduced by the artisans who were Hindu artisans. Because that's part of our history, how it has evolved.
So you feel that this thing should be incorporated in the education system for our new generations?
Very much. Very much. You know, there's a saying in Konkani. We don't need to learn about the world. Learn about your own home. There's a saying in Konkani, because a python was going, a earthworm also decided to join, got crushed and died. That's the story of Goa actually. I keep on talking about the concept formation is taken away. We being agrarian society, you know, the first step in agriculture, when you put the seed for sprouting, आम्ही कोंकणीन म्हणटा मिरगाच्या पावसार बी घालता एंड इफ वी हॅव टू टीच एग्रीकल्चर टू आर चिल्ड्रन हाऊ वूड यू ट्रान्सलेट दॅट वॉट इज मिर्ग दिस इज वॉट आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सी दिस इज द सॅड पार्ट यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर्मेशन इज बिंग डिस्ट्रॉइड कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर्मेशन इन अ चाइल्ड कम्स विथ लँग्वेज द डिफरंट थिंकिंग आर थिंकिंग वॉज अलॉंग अ लँग्वेज you know, that is changing.
True. I think I am going to end this conversation by saying one more aparibha. The reason why this is happening is because in Konkani there is a saying, Makadacha Atankoldi, we have given the decision making in the hands of the wrong people.
Yeah, how can you change that? You know, the thing is, what is really sad is people, you know, what is the difference between the West and this part of the world? In the West, ideas like museums or art centers, they are flourishing. It's because they are headed by professionals, people who come from that background. Whereas here, it is headed by bureaucrats. It's the bureaucracy that is destroying the arts in this country. That needs to change. You know, and for anyone to get into this thing, you know, what we need to really develop in children, youngsters, is that information is not just about books. Information is not just about internet, you know, reference. You know, like my work, there's a saying in Konkani, Kashti budanastana nustya mayana. Without dipping your loincloth, you can't catch fish. If you really want to do something, anything that you want to do, you need to go really deep to understand that.
Thank you very much, sir, for spending such a wonderful time with us. And I'm sure that my viewers are going to be totally enlightened and they will get the right chitra, because their chakras are going to start moving and it will show through their krutis. Am I right?
Hmm.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
So here we are, ladies and gentlemen. You have seen what is the Goa Kruti. It is still in the formation stages. You have been very privileged to see the preview of this. Now what we will do, we'll close this and come out. There. Now, we have been shown around by this gentleman, Mr. Sushant Fernandez. Thank you, Sushant Bab, for showing us around the place. Very nice. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of this tour of Goa Kruti, where you have seen the different professions as were practiced during the Portuguese time, a colonial time. Many of these things are now going behind the curtain of time. It is our duty to see to it that we protect all these things. If there are certain things lying with you, please donate it to museums. You have got Goa Kruti here and other museum, Goa Chakra and Goa Chitra also. If you have got these things and they are being a burden to you, don't throw them out. Please give them. Please call them. Like they said that they have got a Facebook page, or you can see an email over here. Please convey to us and we will convey it to them. You will be helping the future generations to see what was there in the earlier generations. So again, remember this email over here and write to us. So, bidding you goodbye, signing off, bye-bye.